To all those people watching, I like to remind everyone that this video is not made for kids. It's for older fans and adults. Enjoy the fucking video! Halloween was fast approaching on the island of Sodor. The engines loved seeing the stations decorated with spooky ornaments and all the children dressed in their costumes. Most of all, they loved hearing ghost stories. Each year, Edward told stories of ghost engines, haunted sheds, and other strange railway phenomena. This year, he told them about the bad luck brake band. "They say," he finished ominously, "it roams the rails in pursuit of the engine who bumped it to pieces. Legend has it that if you see it roll past, you'll never make it back to your shed. You'll find yourself in the scrapyard instead." The engines gasped. They were speechless. "Well," Edward smiled, "enough stories for now. It's getting late. Off to sleep all." The engines tried to sleep, but they still chatted excitedly about Edward's story. All except Oliver. "It's not right," he complained to Duck the next day, using scrap and a cheap ghost story. "It's all in the spirit of the season," Duck advised. "Edward is the last engine who'd want to cause any offense. He knows scrap is serious, but we're safe here." "Huh, he should try being on the run with the threat of scrap looming closer every day," Oliver huffed. "Anyhow, ghost stories are a load of rubbish." He snorted indignantly away. Duck chuckled to himself. Oliver was grumpy the rest of the day. He was grumpier still when he was ordered to help organize the harbor yard on Edward's branch line. By the time he arrived, a low mist had rolled in from the sea. Bill and Ben were chatting nervously to one another. "I hope Edward takes care tonight," quivered Bill. "What if the bad luck brake van finds him? Maybe we should tell another engine to take his train," added Ben. "Like Oliver." "No chance," grumbled Oliver. "Bad luck, just like Edward's story, is nonsense. You two should be wise to focus on your work instead of that rubbish." Bill and Ben said nothing more and scampered away. When night had fallen, Oliver was eager to leave. The yard manager came to see him.
"The brakes on the van for Edward's night train aren't working properly," he explained. "Could you be his back engine? That way, you can get back to the junction and Edward can pick up a spare van at Wellsworth."
Begrudgingly, Oliver agreed. He found Edward coupled to the trucks, napping on the quay. Oliver then noticed a faulty brake van on the opposite line, and had a devious idea. He buffered up behind the van and gave it a nudge. With a creak, it began to roll down the line, past Edward. Quickly, Oliver changed tracks and came up behind the trucks. Edward woke with a start. "Goodness," he cried, "what's going on?" It was then that Edward noticed the brake band rolling wearily alongside. It disappeared in the mist as Edward felt himself being pushed along. Out in the darkness of the countryside, Oliver started wailing ghoulishly. Edward was at a loss for words. Then he saw the red signal ahead. He braked hard, but Oliver, too busy playing ghost to notice, kept pushing. "Stop!" cried Edward. Too late, Edward felt his wheels bump over the points, along the sleepers, and off the line. Some of the trucks came off too, and the train finally stopped. Edward sat crooked on the line side, his front bogey damaged by the crash.
"Help!" cried the trucks. "It's the bad luck brake van, Edward!"
"Actually, it's me," came the quivering reply. Soon, Boker arrived with the breakdown cranes. And the Fat Controller.
"What, Oliver?"
he began.
"I've certainly never seen any of Edward's ghost stories taken this far, and I prefer if it didn't happen again. Edward will be at the works for quite some time, and you will be helping Boker run the line until he returns. Perhaps it will teach you to be more sensible."
"Yes, sir," sighed Oliver. Soon Edward had been loaded onto a flatbed. Oliver rolled alongside.
"I'm sorry, Edward," said Oliver. "I certainly didn't mean for things to go this far."
"My stories don't usually get this sort of reaction," chuckled Edward.
"Dak told me how you felt, and I'm sorry too. I certainly never meant to upset you."
"And I didn't mean for things to go this far," frowned Oliver.
"Ah, well," smiled Edward. "You did give me a good scare. Look at the bright side. I'll have plenty of time to think of better, scarier stories at the works."
Oliver just had to laugh.